What's going on, guys? Gunster back again on another MLB The Show 19 Diamond Dynasty video. We just got done watching the MLB The Show live stream over on Twitch Sony San Diego Studio, where we saw the July Player of the Month flashbacks as well as Topps Now cards. And I gotta say, I'm really happy. They did decide to completely cut golds out of the Player of the Month program, and they're all going to be diamonds, and then the Lightning card is still there. And then for Topps Now, they cut out the silvers. The silvers are now golds, and then the rest are diamonds. That would have been golds before. So I believe it's going to be 8 diamonds in the Player of the Month, then the Lightning Diamond, and then about 8 Topps Now diamonds and 4 golds as well. The pack is still going to cost 15,000 stubs. It's not going up. But of course, I think this is a really good move just because we have so many good cards in the game right now. It really made no sense that they were releasing silver cards. So I'm glad that they did do away with that. But we're going to get right into all the new players that they did reveal and the statistics. But first, if you guys could leave a like down below on this video and subscribe to the channel if you guys are new. Really working a lot of hours to get these Diamond Dynasty videos out to you guys. Hopefully you guys have been enjoying the gameplays and whatnot recently. But with that being said, let's get right into it. They did go a little bit out of order. Let's start with the golds. I did miss one gold stats, Mike Yastrzemski. Mike Yastrzemski, crucify me for that one. I'm sorry, but starting off with Matt Theis, we have 78-89 contact and power versus righties, 51-52 splits versus lefties. I really don't know much to say about that card. It's not really that great. Not exactly my cup of tea. Then we also do have Steven Matz right here, 94 stamina, 76 hit 9, 66 K9, 76 walk 9. He throws a sinker, a changeup, a curveball, and a slider. Once again, it's a gold starting pitcher right here. Nothing too crazy. I actually did miss one more. I don't think they showed the stats for Philip Irvin, but he has an 82 overall Topps Now card, and then Mike Yastrzemski as well, an 80 overall Topps Now card, which I did miss the stats, and it's an 80 overall. You could probably use your imagination and, you know, kind of expect what you're going to see for that. But moving on to the diamonds, like I said, very short gold round getting onto the diamonds right away. We have Oscar Mercado right here for the Cleveland Indians. 95-89 contact, 50-55 power, 82 vision, 88 speed, 76 fielding, 68 arm. I know the stats on the right are a little bit harder to read because the crew were over in that corner, so I apologize for that, but there's not really much I can do about it. But he has good contact, you know, good contact, good speed guy right there, 85 overall from the Topps Now Cleveland Indians. Definitely been really hot lately, giving the Minnesota Twins a run for their money for that AL Central Division title. Moving on, we have a Travis d'Arnaud right here, which of course you guys know I am very happy about as a Tampa Bay Rays fan. And this card is actually really good. They definitely did not skimp on this one. 99-118 power versus lefties. Really good splits. And then 83-64 splits versus righty. 62 vision. 46 speed. 70 fielding. 80 blocking. 62 arm strength. So not great behind the plate, but a really good catcher. I think this could honestly be well versed for a lot of people as their backup catcher, you know, and just have him in there if you need a pinch hitter. I think that is a very good option. We have an 88 overall Player of the Month, Danny Santana, who can literally play everywhere under the kitchen sink except for the catcher position. He has 90 and 113 contact, 72 104 power versus lefties, 50 vision, which is not great, but you know, it's not the worst, I guess. We've used Joey Gallo for how long? 57 fielding. That's not acceptable. That is a little bit not too great right there, but you know, he can play everywhere. I probably would recommend playing him at first. I wouldn't necessarily want to move him too much around because he'll get even worse defense. It's still going to be common nonetheless. And then 67 speed, a switch hitter. It's a cool card though. You know, that's kind of the trend that we have unfortunately noticed with a lot of these Player of the Month and Topps Now cards, is that they just do not have that great of defense. But you know, there's not really much that you can do about that. Here we have an 88 overall Patrick Corbin. Really nice, that three-headed monster in this Washington Nationals rotation. Corbin has 91 stamina, 78 hit 9, 91 K9, 79 walks per 9, 90 home runs per 9, 5 pitches slider, 2 fastballs, 2 seam and a 4 seam, changeup and a curveball. Of course, he does not throw all that hard, 92, 93 miles per hour, but the curveball goes to 68. That is even slower than Kershaw's, you know, Kershaw's, Roy Oswalt, guys that have super slow EFIS type curveballs right there. Another Topps Now diamond, we have JBJ, Jackie Bradley Jr. Offensively, of course, not too much to say about this one. 74, 54 contact, 90 power versus righties, 53 power left. But of course, this is more of a defensive oriented card. 95 arm strength, 85 reaction, 81 fielding, and then 61 speed out there in center field for Jackie Bradley Jr. We still do have quite a few more diamonds. Like I said, this is all diamonds more so, except a couple golds. We have Tommy Canley right here. He had a phenomenal month, I think, had an ERA of 0.60. Very good for the Yankees. Been one of the best relievers out of that pen this year. 105 hit 9, 104 K9, 73 walks per 9. Not great, but definitely not bad, because he also does, he has an average pitch control of 85, which is pretty good. 94 home runs per 9, 108 pitch clutch. Only 3 pitches to fastball, slider, and changeup, but if you're only going to have 3 pitches, that's usually what you want. A nice breaking pitch, a changeup to mix speeds, and then a 4-seam fastball coming in at 98 miles per hour. So the Tommy Canley looks like a pretty damn good card, to say the least. Former Yankee great Sonny Gray right here, 91 stamina, 85 hit 9, 98 K9, very nice. 73 walks per 9, 79 home runs per 9, 80 pitch clutch. Throws 4 different pitches, 2 fastballs, a 2-seam, a 4-seam, a 12-6 curveball, and a slider. Gonna throw about 94, 95 miles per hour on that 4-seam, and then, you know, 2 breaking pitches. It does definitely hurt from the lack of a changeup, but I think this card could be pretty nice. It does look like decent statistics right there. Another current Yankee, we have Didi Gregorius, which I was pretty sure this was going to happen. 91 overall shortstop, 101, 94 contact, 91, 60 power versus lefties, but he still does have good contact at a 94. And then 102 vision, so I think he's definitely going to be a very dependable lefty hitter, lefty on lefty, but of course righty is his power side. And then decent defense, 73 fielding, 73 arm, 73 reaction all the way across the board. It's not great, but it's not that bad. I think it is definitely serviceable out there. 64 speed on top of that. Here we have Ramon Laureano. A lot of people hoping he get the lightning card. He did not, but his card still looks really good. They did boost his defense up to an 80, so he does have gold fielding, maxed out arm strength at 99. 89 reaction, 79 speed, get a ball hawk, a lot of stuff out there in center field. And then 96, 108 contact, 95, 66 power versus lefties. Unlike Didi, he doesn't have 102 vision. He only has 49, which is not great. But versus righties, I think he's a really good hitter. But I think the main reason you're getting this card is most likely for the defense. You know, insane cannon out there, and also really good range, 80 speed, 80 fielding, 89 reaction. Another reliever, we have Seth Lugo right here. In my predictions, I was between Seth Lugo and Tommy Canley getting it, but obviously I didn't know they were going all diamonds. But Seth Lugo had a 0 ERA, did not give up a single run. In the month of July, he had a 109 hit 9, 94 K9, 90 walks per 9, 96 home runs per 9, 108 pitch clutch, really, really good per 9s, 5 pitches, 4 seam curveball, 2 seam slider, and a changeup. Gonna throw about 96, 97 miles per hour. This looks like a nice card, you know, maxed out all on 5 pitches. So he's gonna be able to throw a variety of different stuff, throw a, you know, have a bunch of different stuff that he can throw at you. And then good per 9s as well, 109 hit 9, and really good control at a 90 walks per 9. Usually a premium for guys like that. Here we have a Mike Clevinger, 89 stamina, 81 hits per 9, 96 K9, 82 walk 9. 4 pitches, fastball, slider, curveball, and a changeup. Gonna throw 96, 97 miles per hour. The hit 9, nothing crazy, which is usually stat I look for. Home runs per 9, also a little bit weak at a 64, so might have a little bit of trouble giving up home runs, but he has good K9 and throws pretty hard. So that's Mike Clevinger right there. Just 2 more diamonds until we get to the big shebang. We have Juan Soto, 102, 94 contact, 95, 80 power, 74 vision, 63 fielding, 62 arm. That is really where he suffers. But he's a left fielder. If you really like his swing, if you really like Juan Soto, you can probably get away with hiding him out in left field. It's passable enough defense with 51 speed. Really good hitter, just unfortunately suffers from that defense. He has can play the entire outfield, but of course I would not recommend that unless you want to drop down to common defense. Finally, our last diamond, we have Paul DeJong. Let's get a righty killer, 105, 115 splits. Of course, he is a righty batter that hits righties better. Some people like that, some people do not. 81, 71 splits versus lefties, definitely no slouch. 83 vision along with it, and then 80 fielding, gold defense, 75 reaction, 67 speed. Only does have 64 arm strength, so that is really going to be a bit of a hit. He can play first, second, and third, so maybe you want to put him at first or second where you don't have to rely so much upon that arm strength, but a very nice hitting card right there. And finally, the Lightning card, we have Yuli Gurriel. I was a bit shocked about this, I guess. I think he definitely deserved it, but I didn't think they were going to go four position players in a row, but they did go with that. Yuli Gurriel definitely deserved it. A third base primary, his live series, I believe, is still at a first baseman. 102, 108 splits versus righties, 81, 113 splits versus lefties, so really good power. 93 vision, a lot of cards like this would not have great vision, but he definitely does at a 93. Discipline at a 37, I don't really think that matters. 73 defense, 66 arm, 72 reaction, and 58 speed. Can play first, second, and left field. That's a bit of a low arm strength for third base, in my opinion. Probably best off playing him at first or second, in my opinion. Not great defense at second base, but still decent enough. It's going to drop down to bronze. Really good hitter, though. I think this is a pretty good card. I have not really used Yuli Gurriel cards like that, so I can't say so much upon his swing, whether or not it is good. But those are the July Player of the Month and Tops Now flash specs. Unfortunately, I did not hear them talk about anything about gameplay, so that's really unfortunate. But these cards are going to be coming out tomorrow, as always. 15,000 stubs for the pack, all diamonds except for 4 golds in the tops. Now let me know down below in the comment section which of these cards you guys are most excited for, and are you guys interested in going after that 97 overall Yuli Gurriel? Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to like it below. Hope you guys aggressive today. There goes himself. Yeah.